Hello everyone and welcome back to Naughty Threads. And in today's video, I'm going to try a new design, and this is going to be a single step design for which I'm using silk thread. I have taken 6 strands. Along with that, I'm using my crochet hook number 10 and some gold beads. It's a single step design. It gets done very fast. The minute you start, you might find it a little tricky, but as and how you proceed, it's going to get very easy. So I'm going to place the knot on the wrong side, which means the right side of the sari is facing towards me. So first we'll fix the knot. So once the knot is fixed, we'll work 2 chains, and then I'm going to work 1 double crochet next to the knot. So this is my double crochet. So there is 1 double crochet and there is 2 chains. In between there is a small gap. Now all the stitches I am working will go into this gap. So basically we will be working a puff stitch, for which I will yarn over like this, go into the gap, pull the thread and come out. So this is more like working a double crochet, but we are not going to finish the stitch. This is the first stitch I have pulled and it is on the hook. I am going to hold it in place and I will repeat this 4 more times. So in total I will have 5 incomplete or unfinished double crochets. So each time you will pull the stitch like this. So this is my second stitch. Again I'll yarn over, go into the same gap, pull and come out, and this becomes my third stitch, and I'll continue the same way 2 more times. So this is 4. So make sure everything is in place, like all the stitches, because these are all incomplete and this is how it looks. Now is the tricky part. Now you'll have to yarn over and make sure you pass through all the loops like this. So once you do that, our puff stitch is complete, and then we will do 1 chain stitch so that all the stitches stay in place. Now once we do that chain stitch, the puff stitches are kind of locked. And this is where I will add a small gold bead. So once I add the gold bead, I'm going to lock it with a chain stitch again and continue working the next double crochet. Only in the beginning we'll work 2 chains and a double crochet so that the gap is created, but going forward only by working a double crochet, because of the previous puff stitch there is already gap here, so I'm not going to work that 2 chains. So same way we will continue 5 unfinished double crochets to work the puff stitch. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So once you have 5 stitches, yarn over and pass through all the stitches, lock it with a chain and then add a bead, and this is how you will continue. It gets done very fast. Bead is optional. If you don't want a bead, you can skip it, or if you want, you can also replace it with a hanging. So I've worked so much and this is how it looks. It looks more like a slant design, and this is a single step. If you want, you can leave it at this, or you can also add tassels by working chains below this bead. So if you work 3 chains below the bead, in that 3 chain gap you can add baby tassels. Even that will look good, but for now I'm just going to leave it like this. I'm not going to add any kind of tassel. So I will just do 1 or 2 more in case you guys didn't follow earlier. So this is going to be the first double crochet after the bead. And then in this gap I'm going to work the puff stitch. So puff stitch will be 5 unfinished double crochet. So this is my first, second, third, fourth and fifth. So each and every time you come up, you will have to make sure you're pulling this, because we'll have to pull this loop through all the loops that is on the hook. So if you don't pull it longer, then while working this step, you might find it a little difficult. And then we will lock this puff stitch and then add the bead. After adding the bead, I have worked a chain to lock the bead, which is optional. If you don't want, you can directly work double crochet. This is going to be my last stitch here. So again, after one double crochet, I'm going to work five. See, each and every time you'll have to make sure you pull it like this. Again, yarn over. Pull as much as you can. That's 2, 3, 4, 5. So I have 5. I'm going to yarn over and pass through all 5 loops and then lock it with a chain stitch. So with that, the design is complete. I will add one more bead here and then we'll see how to cut and finish. So after adding the last bead, I'm going to work 2 chains and fix it to the fabric, because that's how we started. Remember, we started off with 2 chains here and then I worked the first puff stitch. So same way, after adding the bead, I'm going to work 2 chains and then one single crochet here. To fix it. So with that, see, this is how the design looks. I'm going to trim the thread and then we will knot it and trim the extra. So after I cut the thread, I'm going to pull whatever is there on the needle like this. Make 2 to 3 knots. And then trim off all the extra thread and then apply glue so that no raw edges of the thread is seen. So whenever you are cutting this part, make sure to leave about 1/2 inch and then trim off the excess. Otherwise, there are chances the knot might open. And this is the finished look. So it looks very pretty, especially on soft silk sarees or Mysore silk sarees where there are not many color options, and mostly most of the silk sarees have the golden zari, so you can either use gold bead, or if the saree has silver zari, then you can replace this with silver bead. So I guess that's all in today's video. This is the outcome. Do let me know in the comments what you think about this design, and I guess I shall see you guys soon with more interesting stuff. Until then, take care.